I love a good bum on a woman, it makes my day. To me it is palpable proof of God's existence, eh? Posterior, I also, I love breasts and arms and ankles, elbows, knees. It's the tongue, the tongue, the tongue on a woman that spoils the job for me. Please understand, I respect and admire the frailer sex, and I honour them every bit as much as the next. Misogynist, but give some women the ghost of a chance to talk, and thereupon they go on again, on again, on again, on again, on again, on again, on again. Wonderful thighs and hips, and a sensational belly, I just never noticed her lips. Were always moving, only when we got to the altar and she had to say I do. And she folded her arms and gathered herself and took in her breath, and I knew she could have gone on again, on again, on again, till the entire congregation passed out and the vicar passed on and the choir boys passed through puberty. At the reception I gloomily noted her family's jubilant mood, their maniacal laughter and their ghastly gratitude. Talks to me when I go for a shave or a sleep or a swim. She talks to me on a Sunday when I go singing hymns and drinking heavily when I go mending my chimney pot. She's down there in the street, and at 95 on my motorbike she's on the pillion seat. Whittering on again, on again, on and again and again. When I'm eating or drinking or reading or thinking or when I'm saying my rosary, she will never stop talking to me. She is one of those women who will never use three or four words when a couple of thousand will easily do. Also talks without stopping to me in our bed of a night, throughout the sweetest of our intimate delights. She never gives over, not even stopping while we go hammer and tongs towards the peak, except maybe for a sigh and a groan and one perfunctory shriek. Then she goes on again, on again, on again, on, and I must assume that she has never noticed that she's just been interrupted totally. Unruffled she isn't, as far as I can see. I might just as well have been posting a letter or stirring up the tea. Take a hint, not once she's made a start. I can yawn or belch or bleed or faint or fart. She'll not drop a syllable. I could stand in front of her grimly sharpening up an axe. I could sprinkle her with paraffin and ask her for a match. She'd just go on again, on again, on again, even more. The hind leg off a donkey is peanuts for her. She can ball the balls off a buffalo. Mother of God, I cried one day, oh, let your kingdom come. And in the meantime, mother, could you strike this bugger home? She appeared to me then and there, the Blessed Virgin herself in answer to my prayer. Despite the vulgarity, shimmering softly dressed in blue and holding up a hand, I cocked a pious ear as the Mother of God began. Well, she went on again, on again, on again, on, and I will have to state how very much I sympathize with the rest of the family. Give some women the ghost of a chance to talk, and then upon they go on again, on again, on again, on again, and again, and again, and again, and again. They will go on again, 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 on again.